again, everybody, and welcome to the June 2024 edition of the Mayor's Monthly Video. Got a great treat for you today. We got Cathy Hitt here. She's the president of the Columbiana Main Street Board, and Cathy's got a special surprise for you. She's going to introduce our new Main Street director, and they're going to tell us all about what's going on in Columbiana's Main Street organization and a little bit about the Main Street organization as a whole. Starting with National Main Street Organization, State Main Street Organization, how we kind of fit into all that. And then when they're done, I'll cover a few community news and events items for you that I think might be interesting, and then we'll end this up with a promotional about Liberty Day coming up at the end of the month. So without further ado, I'm going to shake the stick to Cathy and let her tell us all about introduce our newest member of Columbiana Main Street and tell us all about what's going on with Columbiana Main Street.
Thank you, Mayor. Thanks for having us, and thank you for letting us share the excitement that we have about Columbiana Main Street. We are super, super excited to announce that Sara Catherine Pennington is our new Executive Main Street Director, and she's been with us a little while. She's been doing all of our social media, and we've been thrilled with what she's been doing with that. And then we kind of pulled her on in when we went to the Main Street Conference and got her a little taste of that. So I'm going to let Sara Catherine introduce a little bit about herself and her family.
So I'm Sara Catherine Pennington. I grew up in Columbiana. I live in Columbiana currently. I love Columbiana. I always have. I have two little girls. My husband and I met here in Columbiana. And I'm just really excited to get started working on Main Street.
So y'all will be seeing Sara a whole lot down here on Main Street. She's going to be in and out of the businesses, talking with the owners and getting some new members and everything. And so you'll be seeing her farmers market, you know, music on Main, all those special events that we have. So she'll be a lot in front and behind the scenes working. So we're pretty excited. But our Main Street Board consists of eight board members. I'm the president. Ashley DeFranco is our vice president. And then we have Samantha Rush as our secretary. And she's also our legal advice. She's a lawyer here in town. And so she keeps us on where we're supposed to be legally. And then we have Jonathan Flegel. He's our treasurer, and he's also a CPA, and he keeps us on the right track too. So we try to stay right where we're supposed to be. And then we have Allie Payne, who represents the city of Columbiana, Tommy Ponder, which owns PT Solutions, Maggie Burrell, she works for Discover Shelby, but she represents Columbiana just as a community. And then we have Kelly Davis, who is also the owner of Just a Tish. So we're excited to have all those members. All those members bring in a unique part of our board. So we were really excited about that. And we're part of the Main Street Organization of Alabama. And they go by a four-point approach, which is organization, which is our board. It's a working board. We make the decisions of the business going on in our group. And then we have promotion. Promotions are the things like Liberty Day, our 5K run that Joel Dixon is over. And he is our past president. And we love Joel because he has stayed on to do our 5K. We have the farmers market every Friday night. The farm to table event is a beautiful event that we do. It's one of our biggest fundraisers that we do. We have Jonathan Harrison is our chef. And then we have a community of volunteers that come in. And Sara has done that several times too. Witches Ride, the Monster Walk, and we've done Paint the Town Blue, which is the thing for the Owens House that we do. We paint the town blue. The businesses help. And it promotes the Owens House here in Columbiana. The third one is design. Design is our favorite things that we do is the facilities grant. and you'll see where our street has changed. And so we have a lot, like Just a Tish, the painting, we sponsored half of that on their building. The Rush Law, their building, we did some painting and awning. Leaders Coffee House, we did some signs with them. And it's all a partnership, too, that we do. So it's really one of our favorite things that we've done. Flowers, all the flowers on Main Street, we've partnered with the Beautification Board with them. And the hanging baskets, we pay for the baskets and the flowers and everything. But it's a partnership. It's a great collaboration that we do with the Beautification Board. Also, with them, we did new banners on Main Street, too. We collaborated with them, and they did a great job. Some of the murals, we did the one coming into town by the courthouse. We collaborated with the high school on that one, and it turned out really beautiful. We also filled some of the empty buildings that are around. Maggie and her mom came in and did some art in the old buildings right there beside Just a Tish. So, and it kind of filled those spots in. So we love what, you know, that's doing. The economic vitality, it just strengthens our community and promotes retail. We go in, is there, with the businesses, is there something we can do to help you, promote you? And that's one of the things that Sara does and will be doing is going in, getting to know the businesses, getting to know the owners, and promoting their business. She's already been doing that already. So, you know, we're excited about that. And then, you know, volunteers, we always need volunteers. And each one of our things are, they are made up of committees. So if you want to be on the Farm to Table Committee, come be a part of it. If you want to be on the Watering Committee, come and be on that. We really need that. Lisa with the Beautification Board, she really needs that. But any of those things, if there's things that you want to do, come be a part of the excitement, the great things that are happening right here in Columbiana.
Okay, so a couple of things that I'd like to kind of throw in there, and maybe you could talk a little bit about it. We recently, or the City of Birmingham recently hosted the National Main Street Conference, and I believe that was in early May. Mm-hmm. And as part of that, there were tours provided on the Sunday before the conference actually started, and we got one for Columbiana. We brought in people from all over the country to see what we've done with our city and the contribution that Main Street Columbiana has made. And a couple of interesting facts. There was one visitor there from Columbiana, Ohio. And for the folks that aren't aware, Columbiana, Ohio reached out to us and March of 2021 when we had the tornado that went through town, and they volunteered resources to help, and then they came down to participate in the Main Street Conference and took the tour of Columbiana. So I think we're going to have to reciprocate and go up to Northeast Ohio and visit those guys up there. I had the opportunity to attend few months ago, I don't even remember exactly when it was, but they had the 10-year celebration of the Alabama Main Street organization, and I learned a lot about Main Street there. We had the Secretary of Commerce for the state of Alabama there. We had the National Main Street representatives there, and the interesting thing is in that 10 years, and Cathy, do either of you know how many Main Street communities are in Alabama?
I do not.
I don't know that number off the top of my head.
I do know that Shelby County, though, is the only one out of all the counties in Alabama that have three Main Streets, which is Montevallo, Calera, and Columbiana.
I want to say that there's like 40-something Main Street communities in Alabama. I'm not sure what the number is. But the interesting thing is they've had a $1 billion economic impact on the state. Those 40 plus communities with Main Street organizations have had a $1 billion economic impact on the state of Alabama. And that's huge for 40 communities, and all of them mostly being small communities like Columbiana. So Main Street does a lot for your community. You may not see it. You may not realize it. Cathy just showed you and talked to you about all the events that they sponsor. Those bring in lots of folks into Columbiana. They spend their money in this town. And it also does great things for the people who live here as well. So it's a big impact. And then in late May, or actually it was mid-May, I was at the Alabama League of Municipalities annual convention. And Jim Baird, who is the president of the state Main Street organization, also former mayor of Prattville and a former director of the Alabama Department of Economic and Community Affairs under Governor Bentley, was there, and he chatted with me, and he had high praises about the feedback that he had gotten from the tour of Columbiana from the folks at the Main Street convention. So Main Street does a lot for our community, and people just sometimes don't realize it, don't understand it. And so I'm going to piggyback on what Cathy said. They need volunteers and they need help. If you want to help, they would greatly appreciate it. And I think you'd have fun doing it. You would enjoy it, and you'd be doing a lot for the community if you did that thing. And plus, if there's any businesses out there who haven't become members of our Main Street organization, I encourage you to join too, because can do a lot to help those businesses.
We put out more money. Like, we spent over $30,000 in our facade grants. So it's, we invest back into
That's right. It all goes into the community. Mm-hmm. So, okay. Anything else? Sarah Catherine?
That's it. I'm excited to get started.
Well, we're glad to have you. So
we're excited too.
Okay. Well, Cathy and Sarah Catherine, I appreciate you guys coming out and talking to us about Main Street. And I hope you guys get enthused and volunteer, and the businesses out there join up, because you're going to be doing great things for our community. So thanks a lot.
Thank you for having us.
All right. So thanks again to Cathy and Sarah Catherine for talking to us about Columbiana Main Street. So I want to take a few minutes to share some of the community news and events and things that's been going around. I'm sure many of you have seen the new historic downtown Columbiana mural that's painted on the south end of the exterior wall of Blue Agave across from the Shelby County Museum and Archives. And so I wanted to talk to you a little bit about that. So one of the things I think you might have noticed on that thing is as we come into our city, we see these welcome signs, and it says established in 1837. And we've all been trying to figure out for several years now where this date of established in 1837 came from. And so we engaged the Shelby County Historical Society. We engaged the Shelby County Museum and Archives, talked to the Shelby County Probate Office, talked to the Secretary of State's office. I've reached out to the Encyclopedia of Alabama, which apparently is down in Auburn. I haven't heard back from them yet. But we're all trying to find out what happened in 1837 for us to say established. If you read the history of Alabama on that Encyclopedia of Alabama, or if you read the history of Columbiana in that Encyclopedia of Alabama, it says we were incorporated in 1837, but we don't have a record of that. In fact, we do have a different record of incorporation. So since this was a historic marker or mural, we wanted to make sure that we got the history correct. So we didn't use established or incorporated. We decided to use the term founded in 1821. And we got that from the research that we had done through the Historical Society. That's when the first property owners were actually recorded in Columbiana. Prior to 1821, there was no legal recording of property deeds in the state of Alabama anywhere. They had what they called, not squatter's rights, but basically similar to squatter's rights, was the only way that people had of settling in a community. And so consequently, property, there were people here prior to 1821 that we don't necessarily have a record of because we didn't record any property records until 1821. And so naturally, that's what we decided to use as the time that we were founded, and that's what was supported by the Historical Society and the archives as well. Now, obviously, we had to have been here before 1826, because in 1826, we were voted to become the county seat of Shelby County, Alabama. There's actually some chronologies, historical chronologies, that say that the vote that was held in the county to choose the county seat was actually conducted in 1825, but the actual county seat didn't start conducting business in Columbiana until 1826. Now, the name was changed from, we were originally known as Columbia, Alabama. There's another town in Alabama called Columbia. It's on the Chattahoochee River down in the Wiregrass region. And back in the early days of the settlement of the state, 1820s to the 1830s, all the way up to the 1850s, there was a great deal of riverboat traffic that was used for moving goods and people in the state. And it was a commercial hub. So it was kind of a thriving, bustling city. And Columbia claims to have been established in 1820. So somewhere around 1832, there are some records that say it was in 1832. There's one that even says it was all the way back to 1826. The name was changed in Columbiana, and many people believe that it was when a post office was first established here, because obviously they didn't want to have two towns with the name of Columbia in the state of Alabama. So Columbiana was changed to Columbiana from Columbia, and we think in 1832. But for as far as incorporation is concerned, which is what many people believe the 1837 on our welcome signs say, it's what our state seal says. It says established 1837. The Encyclopedia of Alabama says that we were incorporated in 1837. But we have a petition to incorporate, handwritten, that we got from the museum and archives, that was signed by 20 residents of Columbiana in 1853, August 10th of 1853. They submitted a petition to the Shelby County Judge of Probate to incorporate our town. So apparently it was not incorporated before 1853. And then we have a copy in City Hall. This is our record, the city's record, of the incorporation of the city, of an act of the Alabama legislature that incorporated Alabama in 1858. So we used 1821 founded on the mural to sort of, since it was a historic downtown mural, to reflect the actual history and how far back the town goes. And so now we're still trying to noodle around and find out where did this 1837 date come from. We don't want to just discard it, and if there's something real and significant associated with it. Otherwise, we're going to end up having to change our city seal and all of our welcome signs, and we'll certainly do that if we need to. So it was interesting, it was fun, but that's why you see that date of 1821 on the mural. Okay, some other community news and events, some accolades and awards. The Shelby County Chamber of Commerce had the Small Business of the Year Awards. That was actually last month. And we had two nominees from Columbiana and one winner. We had Leaders Corner Coffee and Tea was a nominee in the small business category. The categories are based on the size of the business. And then a winner in the new business category, because it's less than a year old, is McClendon Counseling and Consulting. They were from right here in Columbiana, and so there's a photograph there, Aubrey McClendon receiving her award. Good news, thanks to Allie Payne and the folks who've been working so hard on Liberty Day, we received and got the little letter, a nice little letter signed by Governor Ivey, that we got the Alabama Tourism Grant for our Liberty Day celebration. And that's certainly going to help us pay for some of the fun and entertainment and things that we all enjoy at Liberty Day. So great news for getting that grant. All right, so speaking of Liberty Day, and then also speaking of the Sunset Music and Market. Now, that's the combination of the Farmers Market with Music on Main. We have farmers market starting at 5:30, Music on Main starting around 6:30. We just had the stepdads last Friday night. This Friday night we'll have Cash Domino Killers, and you can see the list of entertainment. Lee Allen Carter, that's, by the way, is Cathy Hitt's son, who was just here talking to us about Columbiana Main Street. They'll be performing on June 21st. And June 28th, which is the Friday night prior to Liberty Day, where we always sort of kick off Liberty Day festivities, we're going to have the Shimmer Band. Shimmer was here in Liberty Day 2021. They were well received, so back by popular demand, we asked them to come back. Daniel Bowen on July 12th, the Goat Hill String Band. I like them. They were here last year. I really like that type of music. They'll be here on July 19th and July 26th. And then I've got the schedule, and you'll see these flyers and advertisements and posters around town with what's going on as far as Liberty Day is concerned. So that's pretty much it for June's monthly video and what's going on around town. So we're going to end this thing just like we did last month, and that's to kind of give you a preview of our headliners. So we're going to show you a video, a promotional video for the Shimmer Band, and then a promotional video for Drake White, who will be our headliner at the football stadium on Saturday night. So until then, keep those cards and letters coming in, and I'll see you next month. Hands up in the air if you're having a good time tonight. Come on.
Lately, times are hard and hearts break like the bank. Oh, yes it do. If you've ever seen Drake play, you know he has something special. When you watch Drake play, it's like watching a preacher who believes in the word stand on that stage and tell it and sell it. And Drake does that musically. Look at us with a picket fence. Don't got a lot of money, but we're making a dent. Old Ford truck with a dog in the back. Now ain't we living a dream? Doesn't matter if I'm singing to 10 or 10,000 people. I'm going to get up there and do it exactly the same, as hard as I can do it.
I want people to walk away from it and go, wow, that guy's got more energy than anybody I've ever seen before. And that band looks like that they're having fun, and they look like a band of brothers. And I would want to be in that band. Look at us with a picket fence. Don't got a lot of money, but we're making a dent. Old Ford truck with a dog in the back. Now ain't we living the dream? Big blue sky, green, green grass. Ain't doing half bad for a half full glass. Kiss me, baby, yeah, just like that. Now ain't we living the dream?
So the song Living the Dream means so much to me because it's how I was raised. Living the dream to me is being out on my property, being on the back porch, having my coffee, having my family around, my dogs. The lyrics just really stood out to me and the imagery in it.
I grew up in a very musical house. We attended a small church there in Hoax Bluff, Alabama, and my dad was a singer, mom was a singer. They sang in the choir, and it was a happy place.
Drake is a go-getter. He's the kind of guy that will be up at 7 a.m. He's got things to do.
What you see is what you get. There's no putting on airs for this guy or that guy. Right under my shirt, oh, with your loving eyes, you pull me back out. But there you go, baby, yeah, making me look good.
I love making people happy and making people, just if I'm evoking feeling, if it's happy, sad, or whatever, then that's what we're doing. Every day when I get up, how can I get better today, whether it be mentally, physically, spiritually? When I'm not singing and playing and making music and meeting people and giving back to people, I'm not happy at all.
The first time I saw Drake, I knew we had to work with him. It was so moving to see, you know, some Bruce Springsteen and James Brown on stage. He commanded the stage, and he was moving like Billy Graham, part Bear Bryant, part William Faulkner, and it was just really something to see.
I lost my job at the power mill to a man and his machine, but you can't replace these two hands with metal bolts and steam. It's in the heartbeat.